Aladdin Creations.
Hello guys, welcome to another video from Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. In our previous video, we already discussed about hemoglobin molecule and beta thalassemia. If you have not yet watched my previous video, make sure you do, as all the basic stuff you need to learn about beta thalassemia are discussed there. It will also help you to understand and all the comparison. Okay, let's start today's topic, alpha thalassemia.
The genetic information needed to produce alpha chains is recorded in the 16th chromosome in humans. Unlike for beta chains, there are 4 genes altogether coding for alpha chains, 2 on each copy of chromosome 16. Alpha thalassemia occur usually due to whole gene deletions. Point mutations are rare, unlike in beta thalassemia. According to how many genes get deleted, there are several kinds of thalassemias. 1 or 2 genes deleted, alpha thalassemia trait. 3 genes deleted, hemoglobin H disease. All 4 genes deleted, hydrops fetalis. Once again, alpha thalassemia trait is usually a symptomless condition requiring no treatment. Hemoglobin H disease, where only one alpha globin allele is functioning, results in moderate to severe anemia, which might require blood transfusions occasionally. Deletion of all 4 alleles is not compatible with life beyond the fetal stage. Fetal death occurs. This condition is also called hydrops fetalis. What we should remember is that, unlike beta chains, alpha chains are a part of both hemoglobin A and hemoglobin F, hence it will affect the fetal stages of life as well. Laboratory diagnosis. The diagnostic tests for alpha and beta thalassemias are somewhat different. Beta thalassemia can be diagnosed using a process called hemoglobin electrophoresis. It is a test that measures the different types of hemoglobin in the blood. Usually there is a hemoglobin A predominance followed by small amounts of hemoglobin A2 and hemoglobin F. In patients with beta thalassemia, the levels of the other two types of hemoglobins will increase with a reduction in hemoglobin A. Another technique that can be used in confirming beta thalassemia is high-performance liquid chromatography, HPLC. Alpha thalassemia, however, cannot be diagnosed simply as that. Alpha chains are a part of all types of hemoglobins. All forms of hemoglobin will be decreased. The diagnosis requires DNA studies and molecular diagnostic techniques. The blood picture will be quite similar to iron deficiency anemia in thalassemia trait patients. Hyperchromic microcytic cells will be evident and target cells will also be seen with poikilocytes. A special feature of hemoglobin H disease is the presence of golf ball inclusions. They are actually precipitated beta tetramers formed due to the deficiency in alpha chains. A full blood count or blood picture may direct you towards suspecting thalassemia, but a diagnostic test is necessary before the initiation of treatment.